Hello students, this is Sushmita, Venpa Biology faculty. So hope you have done the mock test well. So today we'll discuss the answer. Okay, so the first question is, in his classic experiment on pea plants, Mendel did not use. Okay, so he used 7 contrasting characters and they're asking you which contrasting character he didn't use or the which character which he didn't apply, right? So it is pod length. He used stem length or the plant height, but not pod length. So the answer is A. And second question, which of the following is not applicable to RNA? Okay, so RNA, obviously they have 5-3 direction. They have phosphoryl group and hydroxyl group. And they have heterocyclic nitrogenous bases, that is right. And they have this, possess this complementary base pairing, that is also right. But Charcot rule, no, they don't follow Charcot rule. So that is the answer. And third question, male gametophyte in angiosperm will produce. Okay, so male gametophyte in the sense, they are referring to the microspore or the pollen grain, right? Okay, so if we take the microspore, just a second. Okay, so if we take the microspore, it undergoes first mitotic division, giving rise to a big vegetative cell and a generative cell. This generative cell will again divide into two by means of mitosis, giving rise to 2 male gametes. Okay, and you have 1 vegetative cell. So the answer is 2 sperms and a vegetative cell. Here the sperm refers to the male gamete. Okay, right. Next question, which of the following are not membrane bound, which means which they doesn't have a membrane around them. Okay, so you have ribosomes, lysosomes, mesosomes and vacuoles. The answer would be ribosomes. We know lysosome is membrane bound, mesosomes and vacuoles, right? Okay, so next question, fifth question. Okay, the chitinous exoskeleton of arthropods is formed by the polymerization of. Okay, so we know chitin is made up of N-acetylglucosamine. So the answer is N-acetylglucosamine. So sixth question, among the China rose, mustard, brinjal, potato, guava, cucumber, onion, and tulip, how many plants have superior ovary? Superior ovary or they have hypogynous flower. So what does that mean? The ovary is present above all other parts of a flower, right? So in that case, if we take, generally, you can see guava and cucumber alone will come under the category having or possessing inferior ovary, whereas all others, we have China rose, mustard, brinjal. Okay, so these three would be the exact examples under the superior ovary, and potato, solanaceae, liliaceae, all these are examples of solanaceae and liliaceae which possess superior ovary. So in that case, if we count, it is 6. Okay, so other than guava and cucumber, all others will possess superior ovary, or also called as hypogynous flower. So the next question, the function of gap junction is to. Okay, so we have learned 3 types of junction, right? So tight junction, gap junction, adherent junction, right? So the question is, the function of gap junction is to facilitate communication between the adjoining cells for the transfer of ions and small molecules, or to separate the two cells from just to separate from each other, or to stop the substances from leaking, or performing the cementing to keep the neighboring cells together. So the answer is option A. It will facilitate the communication between the adjoining cells for the transfer of ions, small molecules, and some large molecules. Okay, so next question. Which of the following immunoglobulins does constitute the largest percentage in human milk? Okay, so read the question properly. In milk, they're asking you which possess the largest percentage. So it is IgA. In general, if they're asking you which possess the highest percentage, the answer is IgG. So it is in the order of GAMTE. Okay, so this immunoglobulin G has the highest percentage and the E has the lowest. Okay, but since they've asked in milk, we know human milk consists of, or it is called as colostrum, which possesses IgA. Okay, right. So the next question, in mammalian eye, the fovea is the center of visual field. Okay, so we know eye in the retina region, we have fovea centralis, also called as macula lutea. In that region, they're asking you what happens. Okay, so first option is the optic nerve will leave the eye. Second one, only rods are present. Okay, so third is more rods than cones are found. Fourth option is high density of cones occur but no rods. So always remember, macula lutea is a place where we have more number of cones, okay, and no rods. And the optic nerve leaves the eye through the blind spot, which is present below this macula lutea, right? Okay, so the next question. Okay, doctors use stethoscope to hear the sound produced during each cardiac cycle. The sound, second sound heard is, right? So always remember there are two sounds. First sound is due to closure of tricuspid and bicuspid wall. So sound is produced only when something closes, not when opens. Okay, so the closure of tricuspid and bicuspid wall, okay, is the first sound. Whereas the second sound is due to the semilunar valve closure. Okay, so semilunar valves will close down after the blood flows into the vessel from the ventricles. Okay, so this is the answer. 11th question, coconut water from a tender coconut is, right? So they are speaking about the endosperm. In coconut, we have two types of endosperm. One is free nuclear endosperm, another one is cellular endosperm. So these two in coconut is edible. Okay, right. So they are asking the coconut water is what kind of endosperm? It is a free nuclear endosperm. Whereas the kernel which we eat, the white part in the coconut, right? So that is called as kernel, white kernel, which is cellular. Okay, it is the cellular endosperm. So what do you mean by free nuclear endosperm? Is any mitosis we take, first comes karyokinesis, which is division of nucleus, followed by cytokinesis. Imagine only karyokinesis takes place and there is no immediate cytokinesis. It leads to more number of nucleus inside a particular cell. Okay, so that will lead to free nuclear endosperm. Okay, right. So the next question. Okay, so cutting of DNA at specific location become possible with the discovery of. Okay, so we call them as molecular scissors. Okay, so the answer is restriction enzymes. It is called as specifically restriction endonuclease, which cuts the DNA at a specific site, and that specific site is called as recognition site. Okay, so 13th one, which of the following structure is not found in a prokaryotic cell? Okay, always remember, prokaryotic cells are those which doesn't have membrane bound organelles. So wherever you see there's some kind of membrane located, that won't be present in the prokaryotic cell. In that case, the answer is nuclear envelope. Obviously, they will have ribosomes, mesosomes, plasma membrane, but they have nucleus, not a nuclear envelope or nuclear membrane. Okay, so the 14th question is, they are given the events in meiosis and asking us to arrange it in the correct sequence. Okay, right. Okay, so crossing over, synapsis, terminalization of chiasmata and disappearance of nucleus. So always remember, first happens synapsis, that is pairing of homologous chromosomes. Okay, so first would be option 2, followed by crossing over, okay, 1, followed by terminalization of chiasmata, 3, followed by disappearance of nucleus. So answer is A. Okay, right. So next question. The column of water within xylem vessels of tall trees does not break under its height because of. Okay, so whenever you take tall trees, okay, so when the root absorbs the water, it moves up, right? And there is no breakage in between. It just moves in the, without any break in between in a continuous line. That is because of what? So the answer is tensile strength of water. Okay, so lignification has nothing to do with the water movement. Positive root pressure will lead to gap in between, and dissolved sugar and water has nothing to do with the water movement, right? Okay, so the next question is, the imperfect fungi which are decomposers of litter and helps in mineral cycling is, just a second, so it is deuteromycetes. Okay, answer is deuteromycetes. The examples under deuteromycetes is coleoptrichum, alternaria, and then trichoderma. So in short, you can learn it as cat. Okay, so deuteromycetes is cat, which means they are called as imperfect fungi, and they are decomposers of litter and they help in mineral cycling. Okay, so the next question is, the structure that helps some bacteria to attach to the rocks and host tissue are? Okay, so the answer is fimbriae. So fimbriae is responsible for hitting. So how does it look if it is a bacteria? Okay, so outside the cell wall, you will have small bristle-like structure like this. Okay, so this is responsible for attaching that bacteria to rocks or any other host tissue, right? Okay, so the 18th question, the DNA molecule to which the gene of interest is integrated for cloning is called as. So we have taken a gene of interest, which is nothing but a DNA molecule. So I need to insert this DNA molecule into some organism. Okay, so before that, we insert with this particular structure, okay, for cloning purpose. So it is nothing but vector. So mostly plasmid is used as a vector in most cases, right? Okay, so next question, pick up the wrong statement. Protista have photosynthetic and heterotrophic modes of nutrition. Some fungi are edible. Nuclear membrane is present in Monera and cell wall is absent in Animalia. Okay, right. So protista have photosynthetic and heterotrophic mode of nutrition. It is right because if we take under protista, we have chrysophytes, dinoflagellates, euglenoids, lime molds, protozoans, right? So all these five are under protista. Okay, so in which chrysophytes, dinoflagellates, euglenoids are photosynthetic in nature. Okay, and euglenoids, whenever there is deprivation of sunlight, whenever there is no sunlight, they convert themselves into heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, and also slime molds is saprophytic and protozoans are parasitic, right? So all categories are present in protista. So this is correct option. And some fungi are edible. Yes, mushroom, morels, and truffles are all edible, right? And nuclear membrane is present in Monera. It is wrong. Okay, so Monera are all prokaryotes, right? So best example is bacteria. So as I've already mentioned, prokaryotes doesn't have membrane-bound organelles with them. So the nuclear membrane is absent in Monera. And cell wall is absent in Animalia, it is right. So the answer is C. Okay, right. So the next question is, metagenesis refers to, okay, in animal kingdom, right? So metagenesis refers to, the answer is option A, alternation of generation between asexual and sexual phases of organism. Okay, so the best example under this is Obelia. Okay, just a second. Okay, so this is the answer. Example they have given in a book is Obelia. Okay, so always remember when we take in kinds of Obelia, we'll have two forms. Okay, so one form is called as polyp and other form is called as medusa. You take any coelenterata, we'll have either of this character. Okay, so polyp form would be converted into the medusa form whenever it follows asexual reproduction. So medusa would be formed into polyp form whenever they go for sexual reproduction. So polyp to medusa by asexual reproduction, medusa to polyp by sexual reproduction. Keep in clue like PAM, P-A-M. Okay, so polyp, asexual, medusa. So the other way around would be sexual. So this kind of alternation of generation between asexual and sexual phases of an organism is called as metagenesis. Okay, right. So the presence of segmented bodies, whenever the segmentation comes, that is not metagenesis, it is called as metamerism. So don't get confused with these two terms. Metamerism is segmentation. Example, earthworm, right? So metagenesis is alternation of generation between sexual and asexual phases in an organism, right? So the next question is, which of the following events is not associated with ovulation in human female? Okay, so ovulation. Okay, so we know there will be full development of graafian follicle. From that graafian follicle only, the ovum or the egg would be released out. Okay, so release of secondary oocyte. Yes, so the egg is released in the form of secondary oocyte. LH surge, luteinizing hormone would be at its peak during the ovulation time, which is approximately at the 14th day from the day starting day of menstrual cycle. Decrease in estradiol. Okay, so decrease in estradiol has nothing to do with ovulation in this time period, and there won't be any decrease in estradiol or in turn estrogen. Okay, so the answer is decrease in estradiol, which is not associated, they're asking, right? Okay, so next question is, which of the following joints would allow no movement. Okay, we have learned many different types of joints, right? So they're asking you the joints which does not allow any movement. So the answer would be fibrous joint in our brain. Right, so these joints are not movable, right? So 23rd question, match the following list of microbes and their importance. So Saccharomyces cerevisiae, we know it is yeast, right? And we have Monascus purpureus, Trichoderma and Propionibacterium sharmani. On the other hand, we have their function, right? So we know yeast is involved in commercial production of ethanol. So this is first. Monascus purpureus yeast is necessary for producing statin, which is a blood cholesterol lowering agent. Trichoderma polysporum is an immunosuppressive agent. Okay, so the compound, active compound produced by this Trichoderma is cyclosporin A. So this cyclosporin A is responsible for suppressing the immune power, right? So three. And Propionibacterium sharmani is for ripening of the Swiss cheese. Okay, so the option would be D. Okay, right. So the next question is, which of the following plants have inferior ovary with parietal placentation? Okay, so always remember, they will ask you the example which is exactly from a books only. Okay, so if you take the examples from our NCERT book, for parietal placentation, we have two examples. One is mustard and argemo. So mostly they would ask you these two examples only, whichever is present in our or given in our NCERT book. Okay, so how to remember this is parietal, keep it as parents. Okay, so parents, we generally call them as, ma, mother. Okay, so keep this ma as a clue for now. So we have mustard and argemo. So you can see mustard is there. So cucumber, sunflower and brinjal, obviously they don't have parietal presentation. Even if they have, see, they've asked you which has inferior ovary. Okay, so the answer would be mustard. Okay, right. So the next question. Okay, if you suspect major deficiency of antibodies in a person, which of the following would you like for confirmation evidence? Okay, so there's a deficiency of antibodies. So when you look at a person who is deficient of antibodies, if you take their blood serum and see, what you can find it is deficient is, the answer is globulin, serum globulins. So why does it mean like that? So antibodies are nothing but immunoglobulins. So in our blood, we have three important proteins. One is albumin, globulin, and fibrinogen. So obviously, if a particular person, they are found to be deficient of antibodies, in their blood, they will check for the globulins, whether it is present or not. Obviously, they are all the antibodies. So in general, we call them as immunoglobulins. Right? Okay, so that is what I told you, GAMD, right? So IgG, A, M, D, and E. Okay, so next question is, chromatophores take part in. Okay, so chromatophores are those we can see in bacteria, photosynthesizing organisms, okay, which is responsible for photosynthesis. Okay, they will have pigments required for photosynthesis, right? Okay, so next question, acid rain is caused by increase in the atmospheric concentration of, okay, the answer is sulfur dioxide and nitrogen dioxide. So what happens when they mix with the water, they get converted into sulfuric acid and nitric acid, okay, which will fall down to the earth as acid rain. Okay, right. So next question is, during ecological succession, okay, so what does this ecological succession means? So establishment of a new biotic community in a very fast in its primary phase. No, the ecological succession, when it is in the, when they are forming a new community, it won't be very fast, it would be slow because there won't be formation of even soil. So soil formation itself will take millions of years, followed by next kind of plants, right? So you will have starting from hydric to mesic form or xeric to mesic form, it takes longer time, right? So this won't be the answer. The number and the type of animals will remain constant? No. Based on what community stage it is, the animals and their number and their type will differ. Changes lead to community that is in near equilibrium with environment. It is called as pioneer community. Okay, so it is not pioneer community. They come under next. Pioneer is the first set of community which comes during the ecological succession. And the last one, which is near equilibrium, would be called as climax community. Okay, right. So the climax community, which we see is nothing but trees, right? Okay, right. So the gradual and predictable change in species composition occurs in a given area. This is right. Okay, there's a gradual and predictable change, right? So as we all know, if it is generally, if it is in the hydric condition, completely water, it changes into mesic. And if it is xeric, completely a dry land area, it will again convert into mesic, which contains plants and animals, right? So this is majorly formed during the ecological succession. Right, so the next question, the oxygen evolved during photosynthesis comes from water molecules, right? So which of the following pairs of elements is involved in this reaction? Okay, so you can study this in mineral nutrition and also in photosynthesis. Okay, so it is called as photolysis of water, also called as splitting of water. Okay, so this is done by manganese and chlorine. Okay, splitting of water or photolysis of water is done by manganese and chlorine. Okay, the next question, which of the following pairs is not correctly matched? They have given the mode of reproduction and their examples, right? So you can see rhizome banana, it is right. Conidia penicillium is right. Offset water hyacinth is right. But look at the option B, binary fission, sargassum. Okay, sargassum doesn't come under binary fission of asexual reproduction. Right. Okay. So the next question, and for information, sargassum is an algae. Right. Okay. So the next question is, okay, fine. So they have given you a human pedigree and they have asked you to find out what type of pedigree it is, whether it comes under X-linked or autosomal. Okay. And also if it is dominant or recessive. Always remember, when a pedigree type of question is taken, you can answer them in two ways. One is to write the genotype under each and everything. Take up the probability, write and check, and then find the answer. Or else you have easiest way to find out under which category it comes. Okay, so generally remember, if it is X-linked or sex-linked, they will have criss-cross inheritance. For example, if in the first generation, if a father is affected or the male is affected, and in second generation, if a female is affected, and again, in the third generation, if a male is affected, maybe this daughter's son. Okay. So again, a male is affected. So you can see male, female, female, male. So if this kind of crisscross inheritance takes place, it is mostly, it would be X-linked only. Okay. So X-linked recessive or X-linked dominant. Right. Okay. If it is autosomal, you won't see this crisscross inheritance. So you can see from this picture only, see a father is affected. And then the next generation, a female is affected and a male is also affected. So obviously this won't come under X-linked. So it must be autosomal only. So to find out if it is recessive or dominant, look at the offspring. See from the offsprings only. So if the affected offspring, okay, if they have a affected parent, if their offsprings are also affected, okay, then only we call them as dominant. Note it down. If the affected offsprings, at least one of the parent must be affected. See, this is affected offspring, this one and this one, right? So they have affected parent, at least one parent must be affected. That is right. And all their offsprings, which means this women's offspring must also be affected. But no, they are not affected. If in case their offsprings are not affected, obviously they would come under recessive only. So the answer is autosomal recessive. In other way, if I tell the, for example, if I take one generation, their parent is also affected and all their offsprings are also affected. If it is yes, then they come under autosomal dominant. So this is an easiest way to do, instead of writing genotype. You can also write the autosomal recessive means, obviously the affected parent will be in the small letter, right? So you can also write the probability either this person would be in capital A, small a, or capital A and capital A. You can write the probability and check. But it takes a little long time, right? So you can use the shortcut to answer. Right. So the next question is, the type of leaves in neem and silk cotton respectively are. So everyone would have noticed how the neem leaf would be. So it is pinnate, whereas the silk cotton is palmate. Okay. And they are compound leaves. So pinnate and palmate compound leaves is the answer. Right. So the flowers are unisexual in. Okay. So just a second. Okay, the flowers are unisexual in, the answer is cucumber. Okay, so unisexual means always remember it is different. So under different, we have unisexual and dioecious. On the other hand, it is same, it is bisexual and monoecious. What does you mean? What do I mean here by different and same is, if both male and female is present in the same plant, okay, or flower, we call them as bisexual or monoecious. If they're present in different flower, we call them as unisexual or dioecious. Okay, so here cucumber is the answer. Which of the following fruit is parthenocarpic? Without the involvement of fertilization, just by spraying some hormones, if the fertilization next embryogenesis process happens and it gives rise to fruits, okay, so that would be, they would be called as parthenocarpic fruits, and the example is banana. Okay, so the answer is banana, right? So pleiotropic gene. Okay, so generally, what does it mean is a gene, okay, which will influence us more than one character. Okay, you have a particular gene, but they influence more than one character. We call them as pleiotropic gene. Example, you can then feel like phenylketonuria, okay, which is a disorder caused by an absence of an enzyme which will convert phenylalanine into tyrosine, right? So the answer would be controls a triad only in combination of other gene. Is the gene involved during pleiocene? Controls multiple triads in an individual, is expressed only by parental plant. So answer is C. Controls multiple triads in an individual. Okay, so more than one character. Right. So the 36th question, which of the following is not a function of the skeletal system? Okay, so storage of minerals, production of body heat, locomotion, production of erythrocytes. So the answer is production of body heat. Bones is nothing to do with the body heat. But locomotion, storage of minerals is right. Erythrocytes, RBC, in bone marrow, right? Okay, so that is right. Okay, so the next question is, a jawless fish which lays egg in fresh water and their larvae, amoeboid's larvae, after metamorphosis return to the ocean. So generally, if they tell you jawless fish, remember the class Cyclostomata. Okay, cyclo means circle, stomata means opening. So the fish will have circular opening with no jaws, okay, and they will lay egg in fresh water, okay, and after metamorphosis, after development, they will return back to the marine or the ocean, right? So generally, they are organisms which will live in marine condition, right? So the answer is Petromyzon. Okay, right. So filiform apparatus is the characteristic features of. So remember, filiform apparatus is present inside the synergids, and their role is to guide the pollen tube into the pistil. Okay, right. So only when this pollen tube enters, it will carry the male gametes along with it. Right. So 39th question, they have given the components 1, 2, 3, 4, and they are asking you to arrange them from outer side to inner side in a woody dicot stem. So they are telling this after the secondary growth in stem. So after the secondary growth, obviously the outermost portion would be cork, right? So phellem is also called as cork. Okay. And inner, on the inner side, you will see secondary cortex would be present. Okay, so you'll have secondary cortex. Okay, and then you'll have phloem first and xylem. So obviously we know if this phloem is present, that would be secondary phloem. And then xylem, secondary xylem is nothing but the wood region, right? So obviously what would be the answer? Phellem comes first. Okay, so 39th, right? So phellem comes first. Okay, so 4 first, followed by secondary cortex 1, okay, and then you have secondary phloem 3, and then wood. So option is 4. Okay, right. So the next question, 40th question is, which of the following hormone is not involved in sugar metabolism? So always remember, when sugar comes, the first thing which comes to mind is insulin. So obviously, right, glucagon. These two will do the antagonistic work. So what does insulin do? It will convert all the excess glucose into glycogen. So this is done by insulin, whereas the glucagon does the opposite work. It will convert the glycogen to glucose and supplies them to the cells. Okay, right. So cortisone also plays an important role during, sugar metabolism, and aldosterone doesn't do that work. Aldosterone is a mineralocorticoid responsible for sodium and all other mineral reabsorption. Okay, right? So that is not an answer. Right. So 41st question, golden rice, just a second. Okay, it's a genetically modified crop plant where the incorporated gene is meant for the biosynthesis of. Okay, so golden rice, by means of genetically modification, what we have introduced is vitamin A. Okay, so this is the answer. Right. So 42nd, outbreeding is an important strategy of animal husbandry because it, okay, it is useful in producing pure lines of, if we take the question, okay, it is useful in producing the pure lines of animals. It is useful in inbreeding depression. Okay, so expose harmful genes that are eliminated by selection helps in accumulation of superior genes. Okay, so before learning what outbreeding is, I'll tell you what inbreeding is. So for 4 to 6 generation, if a mating takes place between a closely related individuals, that will lead to inbreeding depression. We're speaking about animals. So closely related animals, which have similar ancestors for 4 to 6 generation, okay, that kind of mating would be called as inbreeding. We'll get pure lines. Okay, so the offspring which we get would be exactly same as that of parents. So the offspring which we get would be called as pure lines. So what happens is, if this continues, it will lead to inbreeding depression, which means their productivity will become low after a particular time. So what happens, in order to overcome this inbreeding depression, that animal has to be done with outcrossing, which means under the same breed, they allow them to mate with another animal, but from a different family, not family in the sense I'm telling you, not from the same ancestor. Okay, from a different ancestor. So that is called as outcrossing. Okay, so outcrossing comes under outbreeding. Outcrossing, crossbreeding, interspecific hybridization, all these three will come under outbreeding. So it is useful in overcoming the inbreeding depression. Okay, fine. So next question, a gene showing co-dominance will have. Okay, so co-dominance, as the name indicates, both are equally dominating to express their gene, right? So the best example is ABO blood group, in which the A and B equally dominate, okay, showing both their phenotype. So you have a blood group called as AB, right? So both the alleles are independently expressed in the heterozygote. Okay, so which of the following hormone, though synthesized elsewhere, is stored and released by the master gland? Okay, so master gland, which they are mentioning here, is the pituitary. Okay, the hormones which are produced elsewhere but stored in the pituitary. So if that elsewhere is nothing but they are mentioning here is the hypothalamus. Okay, so two hormones are produced by hypothalamus, but it goes and stores in the pituitary gland, exactly in their posterior pituitary gland. Okay, so what are those two hormones? One is oxytocin, another one is vasopressin. Vasopressin is also called as ADH. So always remember, okay, so vasopressin and oxytocin are produced by the hypothalamus, but it is stored in the posterior pituitary gland. Okay, so the answer is, instead of giving vasopressin, they have given the other name, ADH, antidiuretic hormone. Okay, so 45th question, increase in concentration of toxicate at successive trophic level is known as, okay, from one trophic level to the next, if the toxicant's amount increases, that would lead to biomagnification. The example which they are mentioned in a book is DDT and mercury. Okay, right. So the next question is, industrial melanism is an example of. Okay, so industrial melanism is based on what type of era they are in. The moth will, evolve. For example, we have two moths, right? So light moth and dark moth, based on which kind of era they are in, before industrialization or after industrialization, the nature will select the one which will try to escape from that condition. So it's called as natural selection. Okay, right. So next question, the primary dentition in humor differs from the permanent dentition. Okay, so they are telling about the milk teeth and permanent teeth. In not having which of the following type of teeth, the answer is premolars. Okay, so if I take the milk teeth, their dental formula is 2102. The lower jaw is 2102. Incisor, canine, premolar and molar. Whereas in the permanent teeth, it is 2, 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3. So I'm telling about one half of our teeth. So if I make it into two, it refers to the other half also, right? So again, incisor, canine, premolar and molar. They're asking you, okay, so not having one of the following type of teeth. So obviously it must be premolar, which is at least present two in a permanent, but not even one in the milk teeth. Okay, so the answer is premolar. Okay, next question. The wheat has an embryo with one large shield-shaped cotyledon known as, the single cotyledon is known as scutellum. Okay, so scutellum is the cotyledon, right? So intrinsic rate of natural increase is represented by, so we know we have growth model, right? So in the growth model, we'll write a formula like this, right? So exponential growth model, and we have logistic growth model. In exponential growth model, we have R, right? Which is birth minus death. So this R is referred to as intrinsic rate of natural increase. Okay. Next question, which of the following biomolecules does have a phosphodiester bond with them? Okay. So the answer is nucleic acid. Between one nucleotide to the other, there is 3-5- phosphodiester bond. Okay. Right. So the term linkage was coined by, okay, T.H. Morgan. So Morgan used Drosophila as his model organism and studied this linkage, right? Okay. So which one is a wrong statement? Okay, so mucor has biflagellate zoospore. It is completely wrong. Mucor has no flagella. Okay, they don't have zoospore. Instead, they have zygospore. Okay, right. So this is the wrong option, but we'll see the others also. Haploid endosperm is a typical feature of gymnosperm. It is right. In angiosperms, we have our endosperm is triploid in nature, whereas in gymnosperm, they are haploid. And in brown algae, we have chlorophyll A, C, and phycoxanthin, which is right. Archegonia is found in bryophyte, pteridophyte, and gymnosperm. This is also right. Okay, so the answer is A. Next question, ectopic pregnancy. So we know the fertilization generally takes place in the fallopian tube, and the development of the fetus after the embryo form, zygote formation will take place in the uterus. If that doesn't take place properly, it will lead to ectopic pregnancy. What does that mean? The implantation of the developing embryo must be in the uterus. If in case if it doesn't move to the uterus and the development of the zygote takes place in the fallopian tube itself, that would lead to ectopic pregnancy. So the implantation of the embryo at the site other than the uterus. Okay, so imagine if this is the fallopian tube. Okay, so you will have, maybe this is uterus. Okay, you will have ovary here. Okay, the fertilization will take place here. Sorry. Okay, fertilization will take place here. So after the fertilization, after fertilization, the zygote will develop and it will reach the uterus where it gets implanted. If it doesn't get, doesn't move from that place and gets implanted here, somewhere here or anywhere other than uterus, if that implantation takes place, that will lead to ectopic pregnancy. Okay, right. So 54th, most animals that live in deep oceanic waters, okay, will be detritivores. Why they will be detritivores? Because since they're in deep oceanic water, they will not have sufficient sunlight. So obviously, okay, they'll be decomposers. Okay, right. So which of the following, disease is caused by a protozoan, right? So influenza, virus, amoebiasis, protozoan, filariasis, filarial worm, animals, right? So we have syphilis, which is caused by bacteria. So the answer would be amoebiasis. Okay, right. So it is, the causative agent is Entamoeba histolytica. Okay, right. So the next question, which of the following interaction where both the partners are adversely affected, which means two species interaction is completely negative, it would be competition. In predation, one would be benefited, other would be affected. Parasitism also, one benefit, other gets affected. In mutualism, both the species will get benefited. In competition, both would be adversely affected. Okay, so 57th question. Okay, identify the correct order of organization of genetic material from the largest to the smallest in terms of size, right? So if you take largest, it would be genome, followed by chromosomes, and then we have gene is nothing but nucleotide, right? Group of nucleotide. Okay, so answer is B. Okay, so next question is, a colorblind man marries a woman with normal sight who has no history of colorblindness in her family. What is the probability of a grandson being colorblind? So first, whenever such kind of problematic question comes, look for what disorder they are speaking. So first, colorblind they have mentioned, right? So colorblind is an X-linked disorder, which means you must use XXXY for parents. This is the first thing, right? So a colorblind man. So obviously, man means they are denoted by XY. Since he is colorblind, in X, we write C above it. Okay, so you shouldn't mention C above Y because it's an X-linked inheritance. Okay, and he marries a woman with a normal sight. Okay, so he marries a woman, she is normal, so XX. Okay, who has no history of colorblindness in her family, which means, so this woman which I mentioned here, her parents have no history of colorblind. So she would be normal, obviously, so XX. Okay, so what is the probability of their grandson being colorblind? So if this is the case, first we'll write, like how we'll mention, we'll write XCY, okay? And then we'll mention the female, XX normal. So the offspring which we get would be XCX, right? XCX, XY, and XY. So what happens is, if they get four offsprings, out of which the female would be carriers, complete all the female would be carriers of the disease, carriers in the sense they carry the defective gene, but they don't express that colorblindness, right? They are not affected by this colorblindness, whereas the male is completely normal. Okay, but the question is, what is their probability of their grandson being colorblind? Okay, so they're not asking about this generation, they're asking about the next generation. Okay, so obviously, if it is grandson, okay, so let me take this female, right? So if this female, okay, mated with a normal male, what we get is XY, right? So XCX, XCY, XX, XY. So they're asking about grandsons alone. So if we take grandsons, what happens? Generally, whenever they ask you in terms of percentage, if they specifically mention what gender, take the complete gender as 100%. So this box and this box, completely it is 100. So each box would be 50. So 50% of grandsons would be affected. 50% of grandsons would be normal. Right? So that would be the case. Okay? So similarly, it happens with this daughter also. Okay, ma? Right? So if that is the case, what would be the answer? The answer would be, what is the probability of the grandson? Right? So there, generation, next generation is these offsprings, and their next generation would be these offsprings, right? So if that is the case, the answer would be 0.5. So why they have mentioned as 0.5 is 50%, right? So they have mentioned it as 0.5. Okay, I hope you have understood this problem. And always remember, generally, if they tell you what is the probability of the offspring, then take all the four boxes contributes to 25%. Okay, and if they're generally asking you grandson or son or daughter alone, then take the two boxes entirely as 100%. So each box would be 50%. Okay, right. So 59th question in photosynthesis, the light independent reaction, which means they're mentioning the dark reaction or Calvin cycle here, it takes place at, okay, so it takes place at stroma or stromal matrix. Okay, so next question. Which of the following pairs have correct combination? So we have two types of nutracyclic. One is gaseous, another one is sedimentary. So gaseous, we know carbon and nitrogen. For sedimentary, it is sulfur and phosphorus. So the answer is D. Which means if that mineral is present, at least one of their form should be in their atmosphere. So they would come under gaseous. Okay, so obviously carbon dioxide, nitrogen, so both are gas, so they would come under gaseous. Whereas sulfur and phosphorus, they can be seen in soil, so sedimentary. Right. So 61st question, introduction of tDNA into the plants will involve. Okay. So tDNA means tumor inducing DNA, which was actually derived from Agrobacterium tumefaciens, which is a pathogenic bacteria, which causes crown gall disease in dicots. Okay. Okay. So the introduction of tDNA into the plants. Okay. So how can we introduce this tDNA into the plants is by simply infecting the plant with Agrobacterium tumefaciens. Okay, right, so next question. The wings of the bird and wings of the insects are. So if you look at the bird and insect, okay, they have different origin. So they have different origin and their wing structure is also different. Why in the sense, if we take birds' wings, they are composed of bones. whereas the insect is not just a membrane, right? So in that case, they have different structure, but they both perform similar function, which is both fly. So if this is the case, if they have similar function, they come under analogous structures, okay, and they will represent convergent evolution, which means they are from a different family. Because of similar function, they are converging under same. So it is convergent evolution. Okay, so the next question. Okay, so a moss used for packing material for transshipment of living material. So we will use one of the moss for packaging of living materials. So the answer is sphagnum. Okay, right. So next one is human urine is usually acidic because, okay, so the answer would be hydrogen ions actively secreted by the filtrate. So we know human urine formation will consist of three major steps. One is glomerular filtration, wherein the blood is filtered. Okay, this would be the first step. And tubular reabsorption, where the most useful substances like glucose is reabsorbed back into the blood. And the third one is tubular secretion, okay, in order to maintain the pH. Okay, so the hydrogen ions, mostly they are secreted into the filtrate. So the answer would be C. This hydrogen ion is responsible for giving the acidic pH for the urine, right? Okay, what is protoplast means? So generally, if I take a plant cell is composed of cell wall made up of cellulose. Okay, so I'll have the cell membrane inside that and I'll have the organelles inside. If this cell wall is removed, okay, a plant cell without cell wall, we call them as protoplast. Okay, so protoplast is a cell without cell wall. Okay, so 66th question, the species confined to a particular region and not found anywhere else is termed as. Okay, you can see the species in that particular region alone, and that species is found to be endemic to that particular area. So the answer is endemic. Okay. And 67th question, they are asking you to select the wrong statement. W.M. Stanley showed that virus could be crystallized. It is right. And the term contagium vivum fluidum was coined by Beijing. It's right. Mosaic disease in tobacco and AIDS in human being are caused by viruses. It is right. And viroids were discovered by D.J. Ivanovsky. Okay, so this is wrong. Okay, it is coined by a scientist named T.O. Diner. Okay, so this is the wrong statement. Okay, so axial placentation is present in. Okay, so the answer is lemon. Okay, so pea plant, let me tell the answer for all these, would come under marginal. Argemone, I've already told you, parietal is MA, where the A stands for argemone. Okay, so dianthus and primrose, DP. Okay, they come under central. Okay, free central, or let me write free central. Okay, right. So these are all the clues, MADP, all these. You can keep it as mnemonics whenever you're studying this. Okay. So 69th question, a childless couple, they are assisted to have a child through a technique called GIFT. What is the full form of this GIFT? So GIFT stands for gamete intrafallopian transfer. So what does that mean? Imagine a female is not able to produce egg naturally. So what she does is she will receive that egg from another person who would be now called as donor. So that gamete would be introduced into this female's fallopian tube. Okay, so the gamete, intrafallopian tube means inside or within the fallopian tube. If you're placing that gamete within the fallopian tube, okay, so this technique would be called as GIFT. Okay, now the sperm will come in contact with the egg, then the fertilization process will take place. Okay, I'm sorry. I have skipped one question. Right. Okay. So from inside to outside, the correct, say, I mean, following correct order of the following cells in retina would be. Okay. So retina, we know it is made up of three sets of layers of cells. Okay. They're asking from inside to outside. So imagine if this is inside the eye. Okay. This is outside. If you see from inside, the first layer of cells you see would be the ganglion cells. You will have ganglion cells, and then you will have bipolar cells, followed by the photoreceptor, which is in contact with the retina. So totally this retina, right? So in this photoreceptor cell only, we'll see this rods and cones present. Okay, so the answer would be A. So GBP, you can keep it as GBP for your clue. Okay, so totally all these three layer only will comprise of retina. Don't forget this. Okay, so 71, during biological nitrogen fixation, okay, an inactivation of nitrogenase by oxygen poisoning is prevented by. So what happens is nitrogenase is responsible for fixing nitrogen in leguminous plants. Okay, right. So this will, the organism involved is rhizobium, right? So what happens is this nitrogenase will do its work well until it comes in contact with this oxygen. So the main enemy of nitrogenase is oxygen. Whenever oxygen comes in contact, it stops doing its work. Okay, so somehow the plant has to prevent oxygen to come in contact with nitrogen. In that case, lec hemoglobin would be present. It's a pink pigment, which you can see, that will scavenge the oxygen. Whichever oxygen comes towards this nitrogenase, this lec hemoglobin will take up so that it will not reach the nitrogenase. Okay, right, so lec hemoglobin. Right, so next question. An association of individuals of different species living in the same habitat having functional interaction. So different species living in the same habitat and they have interaction whenever it comes to the functional thing. So we call them as abiotic community. Okay, right. So the next question is, name the pulmonary disease in which the alveolar surface involved in the gaseous exchange is drastically reduced due to damage in their alveolar walls. Okay, so what happens generally, alveoli is a sac, like vascularized sac like structure. So whenever a person smokes, okay, what happens, slowly this alveolar walls will get damaged. Okay, so if this damages, the exchange of gases would be disturbed, right? So this could lead to a condition called as emphysema. So the major cause for emphysema is cigarette smoking. And we'll connect this with another chapter, okay, which comes in the 12th portion. That is, this emphysema can be treated by a substance which is alpha-1 antitrypsin. In strategies for enhancement in food production chapter, you will have this term, alpha-1 antitrypsin is used to, treat emphysema. Okay, so whenever you study such things, try to connect all the points related to it. Okay, so Balbiani rings are the sites of what? They are sites of RNA and protein synthesis. Okay, in chromosomes. Right. Okay, so match the columns and identify the correct option. Okay, so they're given thylakoids, cristae, cisternae, and chromatin. Okay, and on the other hand, they have given disc-shaped sacs and Golgi apparatus. Okay, so in this, whatever we know would be answered first, right? So for example, if I take chromatin, chromatin is the condensed structure of DNA. So obviously 4 would be 2, right? So either this one, or this one, right? Okay. So next we will know mitochondria, right? So infoldings and mitochondria, right? So we call them as cristae, right? So 2 would be 4. So again, see, they are confused again, right? Fine. So cisternae, we know cisternae, right? So in Golgi apparatus, we'll have this disc-shaped structure, right? Something like this, disc-shaped structure. So we call them as cisternae. So 3 would be 1. Okay. And thylakoid, they are flat membranous sacs and stroma. Okay. Of chloroplast. Option would be A. So whenever a match kind of question comes, make sure you check for the options which you know clearly. And later you can accordingly match the others which you don't know. Right. Okay. So cellular organelles with membranes are. Okay. Which possess membrane? So let me tell you how. The answer is C. Okay, why I told you C is, always remember ribosomes doesn't have membrane around it. In all these three options, we have ribosomes. So obviously these three won't come. And so the answer would be option C. So whenever such kind of question comes, they'll have one common organelle which they'll mention in all other three options. So but that only you can answer easily. Okay, so auxin, plant hormone, right? They can be bioassayed by the abenocolioptile curvature. So what they have done, you will have a colioptile or the shoot tip. Okay, so whenever the sun's rays falls, this colioptile will bend towards the sun rays, and when they found what was present inside the strip, when they cut the strip and they showed sunlight, this didn't bend. Okay, so finally they found that at the tip of the shoot, there is some hormone which is responsible for this movement, and they finally found it is auxin. Okay, right. So which of the following layers in an antral follicle is acellular? Okay, so antral follicle is graafian follicle is there, right? So in that, they're asking you which is acellular, which is not made up of cell. The answer is zona pellucida. So So zolar pellucida is covering around the oocyte, okay, which is not made up of cells. Okay, right. So satellite DNA is important because always remember satellite DNA or like kind of DNA which doesn't code for any protein. Okay, they'll be like something like AATT, repeated sequences, kind of gene sequence you can see in satellite DNA. Why that is present is because to show the polymorphism in a population and also in an individual which is inherited from parents to the offsprings. So they have told it doesn't code for protein. This is right, but they're not same in all the members of population. So for example, what I'm trying to tell is in my sixth chromosome, just for example, if I have AAA or four times if I have A, maybe for another person, similarly in the same chromosome, in the same position, they might have just 3A. Okay, so this kind of difference would always be there. Okay, so this is only responsible for identifying between them. Right. So option C, they code for enzymes, they have given it is wrong, and they code for proteins needed in cell cycle, it is wrong. Okay, so this would be wrong. Fine. So 80th question, cell wall is absent in. So the answer is mycoplasma. So under Kingdom Munia, we would have learned this, right? So mycoplasma is the smallest living organism with no cell wall. Okay, right. So 81st, in angiosperm, microsporogenesis and megasporogenesis will form gametes without further division? No. Okay, you will have meiosis followed by mitosis, right? And they will involve meiosis, it is right. They occur in ovule, they occur in anther. Both separately it occurs, but they are telling you together it doesn't occur in ovule, together it doesn't occur in anther. The answer is B. So both will involve meiosis. Okay, so microsporogenesis means formation of microspore, which is pollen grain. Megasporogenesis is formation of megaspore inside which we have a female gamete, egg. Okay, so roots play insignificant role in absorption of water. So obviously roots, their main role is to absorb water. See, you have pea, wheat and sunflower, obviously they'll have roots to absorb water only. Look at Pistia, we know it is a plant which you can see in the water habitat. Okay, so obviously if we take in water habitat, the roots could be just free floating. Okay, so we have Pistia, right? So they have nothing to do with water absorption since they are generally hydrophytes, right? So the answer would be Pistia. Okay, which of the following are more suitable indicators of sulfur dioxide pollution in the environment is lichens. So lichen is the mutual symbiotic association between fungi and algae. So we know algae can, since it comes under plant kingdom, it has photosynthetic pigments, it can prepare its own food, whereas fungi cannot do it. So both will have an interaction. What do they do? Algae will provide food to the fungi. In turn, fungi will provide nutrients to the algae. Okay, so this kind of interaction we call as a symbiotic association or mutualism. So they are called as lichens, and they are more suitable indicators of sulfur dioxide pollution. Okay, which means whenever there's sulfur dioxide pollution more in a region, you cannot even see even a single lichen growing there. Okay, right. So grafted kidney may be rejected in a patient view. Okay, so always remember, whenever we are trying to receive an organ from another person, from a donor, okay, two things must be taken into consideration. One thing is blood group matching. Okay, they will see if their blood group matches. Second one is tissue incompatibility or tissue compatibility, right? So histocompatibility, they say, right? They'll check for the compatibility between the tissues of that organ and our body. If these two permits only, an organ can be donated to that particular person. But what happens, most of the time this tissue gets rejected or this organ gets rejected because our body T lymphocytes, T cells, which induces cell mediated immunity, will reject this graft. Okay, so according to the T cells, that is from some foreign antigen which is trying to enter our body, right? So graft rejection is mainly due to cell-mediated immune response. If in case this option is not given, look for T cells or T lymphocytes in the option. Okay, humoral means generally B lymphocytes are involved. Cell-mediated immunity means T cells are involved. Okay, and T cells and T lymphocytes all means the same, right? So 85th question, body having meshwork of cells, internal cavities lined with food filtering flagellated cells and indirect development are characteristic of the phylum. So just look at the question, meshwork of cells. Okay, it's a group of aggregates of cells forming a kind of organism. So Can we tell it as a cellular level of organization? And in animal kingdom, okay, only one phylum will come under cellular level of organization. So that is Porifera. So the answer is Porifera. So whenever you're feeling difficult to learn the animal kingdom, under each phylum, try to learn their specific characteristic alone. Okay, so characteristic for Porifera would be this one, right? So similarly, they'll have coronocytes or collar cells, right? Under each phylum, you will have very specific points for them alone, right? So that alone, if you read also, you can try to answer possible questions from that. Okay, so next question, which group of organism the cell wall will form thin or two thin lapping, overlapping it is, right? So two thin overlapping shells, which will fix together. So the overlapping shells you can see in chrysophytes. Okay, so the example under chrysophytes is diatoms and desmids. Desmids is also called as golden algae. So don't confuse this with the algae. Okay, right. So choose the wrong statement. Neurospores used in the study of biochemical genetics. Yes, they are speaking about fungi here. Okay. So morels and truffles are poisonous mushroom. No, they are all the edible mushroom. Okay, so this is supposed to be the answer, right? So the yeast is unicellular and useful in fermentation, is right. So yeast is the only unicellular fungi, right? So penicillium is multicellular, produce antibiotics, it is right. So option B is the wrong statement. Okay, so next question. In females or in human females, meiosis II is not complete until the fertilization takes place. Okay, so whenever we have the secondary oocyte, the secondary oocyte will complete meiosis II. Oocyte. Okay, right. Only when the sperm comes in contact with it, which means the process is fertilization. Okay, right. Until which it will stop in that stage only. Okay, meiosis II stage. Okay, 89th question. Eutrophication of water bodies lead to killing of fishes is mainly due to non-availability of. So eutrophication is accelerated, enrichment of nutrients in the water. So whenever there's more of nutrients in the water, all the water plants will grow above the soil, above the water surface. So what happens is this will lead to non-availability of oxygen to the fishes, which is grown under. So if this is the water surface, if all the plants grows above it like this, the fishes which is present below will not receive the oxygen. So this will lead to the death of fishes. So the last question, the enzyme that is not present in Succus entericus. So Succus entericus is the other name given for the intestinal secretions or intestinal juice. Okay, so we have nuclease, nucleosidase, lipase, and maltase. The answer is nuclease. So nuclease is a secretion of pancreas, pancreatic juice. So keep the clue as TC plant for pancreas. So trypsinogen, chymotrypsinogen, procarboxypeptidase, lipase, amylase, nuclease. So all these will come under pancreatic secretion. Under intestinal juice, all others will come. And you have intestinal lipase also, pancreatic lipase also. So don't tell me that this also could be answer, right? So the answer is nuclease. Okay, ma'am. So if you have any doubts, you can ask in the comment section and feel free to ask any kind of doubts. Thank you.